Hello, my dear students. Welcome to my computer science class. Today, I am going to discuss the chapter number system. This is the second chapter of your computer science book of class 7, IT Planet. So, students, you know very well that a computer can do calculations very fast. But do you know how? You have learned that a computer understands the machine language. Now in this chapter, we will learn how this machine language works in a computer. So you already know that a computer is a man-made electronic machine. It does not understand the language people use to communicate with each other. Then what is the language that a computer understands? So, computer recognizes only two discrete states, on and off. Because computer has powered by electric, computer is powered by electricity, and electricity has only two states, either on or off. So, this on state is represented by the number 1. While the off stage is represented by the number 0. So now, this number system in which only two digits are used is the binary number system. And in short, it is called as bit. A bit is the smallest unit of data the computer can represent. And you all know that 8 bits, when grouped together, they form a byte. So every character in computer, like all the alphabets A to Z, or numbers from 0 to 9, or the symbols, they have an assigned numeric code. They have a code. And this code varies from 0 to 256. And this is known as the ASCII. These codes from 0 to 256, which represent each character, are called as the ASCII, or the American Standard Code of Information Interchange. So these are the ASCII codes. So in order to understand these codes and this on and off, first we should know what is number system, the different types of number systems, and then we can only understand how computer recognizes the different inputs. So what is a number system? The number system is a way to represent or express a number, like we represent in mathematics. You do a lot of calculations using the different numbers. We use the different digits like 1, 2, 3, 0, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 6. So all these are numbers, and the basic mathematical calculation which you do is by using the 10 different digits. And this type of number system is the decimal number system. Now, broadly, this number system can be divided into two types. First is the non-positional number system, and second is the positional number system. So let us see first what is positional number system and what is non-positional number system. So first of all, let us see what is non-positional number system. In the past, human beings counted on fingers, and for counting beyond 10, they used stones, pebbles or sticks to indicate the different values. And this method of counting uses an additive approach or non-positional number system. So, because in this non-positional number system, the symbols represent the same value regardless of its position. And each symbol represents a number with its own place value. So like the symbols like the tally marks. This is represented by 1, and these two lines, vertical lines, represent 2. The 3 vertical lines, they represent 3, and so on. So all these lines, irrespective of their place, like this line and this line and this line, all these lines, irrespective of their place, they have the same value, that is 1. And it is very difficult to perform arithmetic calculations with such a number system because it becomes too lengthy and too complicated. So as I have told that each symbol represents the same value regardless of its position in a number. So what happens? To find the value of a number, one has to count the number of symbols present in the number. And really it is very, very difficult to perform calculations using this. So an example showing a non-positional number system. In non-positional number system, we can write 1 as a single horizontal vertical line, 2 as 2 vertical lines, 3 as 3 vertical lines, and you can see all these vertical lines have the same value. Now the positional number systems. In positional number system, there are only few digits, and these symbols are called as digits. They have few symbols which are called as digits. And these symbols represent different values depending on the position they occupy in the number. The computer can understand these positional number system. Whenever we type some letter or word, the computer translates them into a number. Because a computer can understand only numbers. Now, the value of each digit in a number is determined by considering the digit itself. Secondly, the position of the digit. And thirdly, the base of the number system. So, for considering the value of a single digit, suppose this is the number 1 to 12. So, here for this 2, the value of this 2 will depend firstly the digit is 2, then secondly its position, the position of this 2 here is 1's place, and thirdly the base of the number system. So if we are considering decimal number system, there are different number systems, we'll study in the next sections. There are different number systems like the decimal number system, octal number system, binary number system, and hexadecimal number system. So thirdly, the value of this digit depends on the type of number system. So these three are the basic values or basic points to be considered in mind while describing the value of a number in case of positional number system. Now, the number system can be broadly categorized into decimal number system, the binary number system, the octal number system, and the hexadecimal number system. So, let us see the different types of number system. Let us study the different types of number system. First is the decimal number system. So, this decimal number system has a base 10, and it is represented by 10 different digits from 0 to 9. That is, it has 10 different digits: 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Each digit has a value based on its position called the place value. And the value of the position increases by 10 times as we move from right to left. So look here, this is 6, and this is, as we know, this is 1's place and this is 10's place. So the value of the number, if 6 is here, it will be 6 1's. But if 6 is kept here at the 10's place, it becomes 6 10's, that is 60. So the value increases by 10 times if we move from right to left. And if we are moving to the 100th position, then 10 times from the 10th place, it is 80. This number is 8. 8 tens is 80, and if we keep 8 here, then it becomes 800, 10 times more. So this is the decimal number system, which we generally study in our mathematics. We use it in our calculations as well. Now the next number system is the binary number system. Binary number system has base 2 and it uses 2 digits, 0 and 1, as I have already told. The binary number system has 2 digits, 0 and 1, and they represent the states on and off. 1 represents the on state and 0 represents the off state. The combination of 1 and 0 from binary numbers, these numbers represent various data, and computer can understand only the binary number system. This is the number format of binary number system. Since we can only use 0 and 1, that is why this number contains only the digits 0 and 1, and we have to write or mention the base here. This is the base. Now, we'll see the conversions later, how we can convert a decimal number to a binary number or a binary number to a decimal number. Now the next number system is the octal number system. So the octal number system has base 8 and it uses 8 different digits from 0 to 7. And while representing an octal number system, we mention the base 8 here. Otherwise, you will not be able to understand whether a number is from octal number system or a decimal number system or hexadecimal number system or a binary number system. So better to mention the base of the particular number system. The conversion part we will do later. Now the hexadecimal number system. Hexadecimal means 16. So hexadecimal number system has a base 16. It uses 16 different digits. How? 0 to 9, the total 10 digits. Then the 11th digit is represented by A, 12th by B, 13th by C, 14th by D, 15th by E, and 16th by F. So, am I clear? A is equal to 10, B is equal to 11. C is equal to 12, D is equal to 13, E is equal to 14, and F is equal to 14. So the students, the primary reason why the hexadecimal number system is used with computers are, first is, it can represent binary values in a more compact and readable form. And the conversion between the binary and the hexadecimal number system is very, very efficient. Why? Since a lengthy number which is produced by a binary number system can be written in a very compact form using the hexadecimal number system, because it has 16 digits and binary number system has only 2 digits. So the number becomes lengthy to handle in case of binary number system, which can easily be compacted by the hexadecimal number system. Now the conversions. So students, in the next part of the video, I will discuss how can we convert one number system to the other number system. And this is the most interesting part of this chapter, the number system, the conversion of binary number system to the decimal number system, and vice versa, the conversion of decimal number system to octal and hexadecimal number system. So students, I hope till here you are clear with all the concepts, so that we can move to the next part of our chapter, that is conversions. Thank you, students.